Hello everyone, my name is Luc Leswal. I'm a PhD student from the University of Rennes in France. In this video, I'm going to present the paper, The Interplay of Compile Time and Runtime Options for Performance Prediction. We wrote with Mathieu Hacher, Gébert Tarnava, Arnaud Blouin, and Jean-Marc Jézéquel. This research paper has been accepted in the System and Software Product Line Conference in 2021. Since it is breakfast time in France, I can help but start this presentation with an example including a croissant and a cup of coffee. But seriously, to introduce properly this example, we first have to present Blender, a 3D open source creation suite. In this case, we use Blender to render a scene composed of 3D objects, here a cup of coffee and a croissant. So Blender takes input a 3D scene, renders it from the point of view of a camera embedded in the scene, and depicts the resulting image. This is a very common process used to produce the animated movies we can see when we go to the cinema. So anyway, Blender is a configurable system, so the end user can tune runtime options to adapt the rendering of to his or her needs. In this example, we use two different runtime configurations. On the top, runtime configuration 1 with the detection of the number of threads, a big tile size, and with the progressive refine enabled. On the bottom, runtime configuration 2, with a single thread, a tiny tile size, and without progressive refine. For both runtime configuration, we measure one performance property and the time needed to render the scene. So for the first runtime configuration, the rendering is quite smooth. In few seconds, we can see the scene without noise. However, for the second runtime configuration, well, it works, but you will have to be patient and wait about 3 minutes to see the entire scene. So if you are in a hurry, we can advise you to choose the first runtime configuration rather than the second. But in this slide, there is something missing, because before being binaries we can execute, software systems like Blender are just source code and we have to compile them at some point. And during these compilation phases, we can select compile time options that may also have an impact on performance. And just like runtime configuration 1 outperforms runtime configuration 2 in this example, maybe there are also better compile time configurations to use in order to increase software performances. So let's see the whole picture with the second example. In this case, we consider X264, a video encoder. It takes a video as input and compresses it into the .264 format. So video encoders like X264 as for instance used by streaming platform when we watch movies or TV shows. And when we want to test X264, the first thing to do is probably to simply get the source code, either by downloading manually the zip file or via the gitclone command line, as shown on the top of this slide. And once the code is downloaded, we go to the root folder and we have to compile it. So assuming we are using make, the command line, the first command line to pass is a configuration step to indicate which compile time options will be activated or deactivated. For instance, passing .configure will enable assembler optimization by default, as for the compile time configuration 1, A on the left. But typing the argument disable ESM will disable them, leading to the compile time configuration B on the right. And like disable ESM, there exist many other compile time options. Many of them are really easy to understand, like enable debug. But others, like bit depth, for instance, sometimes require an expertise in the field of video compression or in the field of the software to truly understand how it can affect the behavior of the software. So once the configuration phases is done, you can call the make command, and if all the dependencies are right and if it works, it creates a binary executable that we can use in command line. This binary accepts runtime options related to the current execution of the binary. So for instance, we can set the motion estimator method to teaser, so that's the left part, the runtime configuration one. Or we can set it to UMH, that's the right part, the runtime configuration two. And then we use x264 and measure its encoding time for all combination of options, so compile time options and runtime options. And like with Blender, depending on the chosen runtime configuration, it will last more or less time to encode the same video. So for the TESA motion estimator, runtime configuration 1, it leads to an encoding process of about 10 seconds, while for UMH, configuration 2, it requires only 3 seconds. But more interesting, choosing the compile time configuration B instead of the compile time configuration A, at the compile time level, multiplies the encoding time by 8, whatever the runtime configuration is. So to predict x264 performances in this case, ignoring compile time options seemed really wrong. And this example illustrates that there exist software systems for which the option chosen at compile time interact with the option chosen at runtime, changing the overall software performances. In this paper, we propose an empirical study about the effect of compile time options on software performances. So we first investigate how compile time options can affect software performances, and then how compile time options interact with runtime options. Before starting the technical content, a word about the motivation of this paper. We can name three main motivations. The first one is to understand the interplay between the compile time and the runtime levels. In the related work, many compilation experts focus on tuning the compiler flags, like O1 for GCC, but do not study a lot compile time options. And in the software availability community, we mostly focus on the runtime options. So to the best of our knowledge, there are only few works investigating the impact of the variability coming from the compile time level, and no existing study including together compile time and runtime options. So this paper is a first step to understand the interplay between these two different levels, at compilation and at runtime, and how it can affect our usage of the software system. As a second motivation, we want to outperform the runtime performances of the default compile time configuration, or compile time configuration in general. So on the developer side, finding the right compile time options to package your software system may be problematic because not every developer is an expert of compilation. So in the real world, when you download a package like Linux package, it has fixed compile time options. And honestly, as a user discovering a new software, I'm already glad when the compilation works directly without requiring an additional dependency. And I will bet that, like me, many users do not change any compile time option and go on for the default one without changing or adding anything. So thanks to our study, maybe we can outperform the default or the fixed compile time options for few software systems. And finally, closer to our topic of interest, there are plenty of research papers automating the prediction of runtime performances with statistical learning techniques. But without saying it, when we build such models to predict performances, we make a needed assumption that the compile time options are fixed to the default. So what does it mean for the model if we change the compile time options? Is it still valid? Do we have to adapt it? So this paper is also the opportunity to delimit the scope of validity of those prediction models. In this paper, we ask two different research questions. The first research question asks if compile time options change the performance distribution of a configurable system. We separate this question into two sub-questions. First, we want to state whether compile time options have to affect software performances. That's Q1.1. and then we quantify how much these performances change between the tested compile time configuration and the default one, that's RQ1.2. After that, we have the second research question, if it is possible to tune software performances at the compile time level. So in other words, is it possible to use this compile time variability to improve the performances of software system before the compilation? And again, we divide these questions into two parts, the first being to prove the existence of interaction between the runtime and the compile time level. And the second one about to how to use this interaction to find a good set of compile time options and tune the configuration system. To answer this research question, we first need data. Our experimental protocol starts with the collection of software measurements. It consists of six steps. In the first step, we select a configurable system processing input data and with at least few compile time options. To illustrate this protocol, we choose X264, the video encoder we already used before. In the second step, after reading the documentation and selecting compile time options that may alter the performances, we generate a sample of compile time configuration C. We use the random sampling, so all values have the same chance to be picked. We depict an example of such a compile time configuration in the case of X264. For step 3, we read the documentation again, but about the runtime configuration part this time, and apply the same protocol and generate a sample of runtime configuration R. So again, we depict an example of such a runtime configuration. In step 4, to test the software system under different conditions, we download different inputs I. In the case of a video encoder like X264, input data I are just input videos. We selected 8 videos having different contents like sports, animation movies, video, gaming, and having different resolutions, so it can have a big resolution or a small one. In step 5, all is ready to gather the measurement of the software system. So we download the source code of the software system and compile it with each compile time configuration of C. Then we execute the binary with all the runtime configuration of R on all the input of I. In the last step, for all this execution, we measure different performance properties P. For X264, we measure for instance, the encoding time, the size of the encoding video, and the amount of data encoded per second. We applied this protocol to 4 different systems. So Node.js, a JavaScript runtime environment, Poplar, a library used to render PDFs, X264, and XZ, data compression tool. So for Node.js, input our JS script of its test suite. For Poplar, inputs are books PDF about computer science, and for XZ, we compress the Silesia corpus. To address the first research question, do compile time options change performance distributions? We simply quantify the variation of software performances with different compile time options. On the left of this slide, we depict 4 different box plots of runtime performances for different compile time configurations. Each box plot is related to a software system, an input, and a performance property. For instance, this box plot shows the variation of the compression time of XZ applied to the input file number 5 for a fixed runtime configuration and different compile time configurations. In terms of results, the figure exhibits that there exist several performance properties, like size, that are relatively stable across the different compile time options. For instance, for X264, the output size of videos is deterministic, and the size do not change across compile time configurations. Some software systems like EZ seem to have stable performance distributions across compile time options. But for other systems, the variations due to compile time configurations can vary depending on the runtime configurations. So for instance, on the figure 2C related to the encoding time of x264, for the fourth input video, there is an interplay between the runtime level and the compile time level. For some runtime configuration, like the ID 120, there is no difference when changing the compile time configuration, while for others, like 103, it varies a lot. And finally, there are systems for which there is always a compile time variation, whatever the runtime configuration. For instance, for Node.js, the operation rate can drop from 120 to 50 operations per second for all runtime configurations. In the second part, we will see how much we can gain in terms of performance compared to the default compile time configuration. To study that, we first introduce the notion of performance ratio. So for a given compile time configuration C and a given runtime configuration R, we call the performance ratio of C and R the ratio between the performance of the runtime configuration R executed with the source code compiled with the compile time configuration C over the performances of R but compiled with the default compile time configuration. A performance ratio of 1.4 would suggest that the performances of C is worth 1.4 times the runtime performances of the default compile time configuration. On the table 2A, we depict the average performance ratios for different runtime and compile time configuration, as well as their standard deviations. On the table 2B, we depict the best ratios obtained for all configuration. And by best, we mean the minimal execution time and the maximal amount of operation or data processed per second. In average, for compile time options, the encoding time of x264 applied on the first input is worth 3.33 times the encoding time of the default compile time configuration. Results show that for size, it is not shown in tables, but ratios are all equal to 1, with very low standard deviation. So we cannot gain anything significant by changing the compile time configuration for the size. There are systems like Poplar and XZ that are overall not so sensitive to the change of compile time configuration. In fact, these results are good news, since for this system we can ignore the compile time level and focus on the optimization of the runtime configurations. For x264, the default compile time configuration is quite good compared to our compile time configuration. We cannot gain so much encoding times or encoding data per second, which means the developer did a good job when choosing the compile time options. And finally, there are variability across inputs. So overall, we cannot gain so much for Node.js, but for few inputs, for instance for the input number 8, we can multiply up to 2 times the number of operations processed by seconds. So the interplay of runtime and compile time options can also vary with the input data fed to the software system. Then we address the second research question, how to tune software performances at the compile time level. We first study how runtime option and compile time option interact. To do so, we consider two indicators, the Spearman correlations between performances of different compile time configurations, that's figure 3A, and the random forest importances when predicting the performances of software systems, that's figure 3B. We highlight two main results for Node.js, the most extreme case of interactions. There are high positive correlation for many compile time options in figure 3A, but also low correlation for other compile time configuration. This shows that compile time options alter runtime performances ranking. In all cases, both compile time in red in figure 3B and runtime option in green in the figure 3B are important to predict Node.js performances. So this shows there is an interplay between compile time and runtime levels. In the last part, we try to use these interactions in order to predict the best compile time configuration for the software. We use a random forest algorithm to predict Node.js best compile time configuration. We split the data into two parts, training and validation, and vary the training size to see how much data we need to be able to give a good prediction. We use the training set to train the random forest algorithm, and the validation set to predict the best compile time configuration, and depict the performance ratios between the best compile time configuration predicted by the algorithm and the default compile time configuration. We also depict the prediction of an oracle predicting always the best compile time configuration to show the upper limit reachable with our algorithm. Results show that there are mostly minor improvements, about 5% in general, but for few inputs, it can reach 25 over 50% of performances for inputs 3 and 4. In general, we do not need much data to be able to effectively predict a decent compile time configuration, whose performance is close to the one predicted by the oracle. So it is just a simple example, but it proves that it is yet possible to tune the software at the compile time level. In conclusion, we conducted an empirical study about the effect of compile time options on software performances. As a takeaway message, we just want to say that compile time configuration matter. And we show it is possible to tune software system at compile time, but with a simple and maybe naive example. As future work, maybe we can apply more advanced method of the state of the art on this problem. This concludes our presentation. Thank you for listening and see you all in September.